How you doing? I am Richard, and I am dumb. I am dumb is an acronym for Diary of a Black Man. Today, we're going to talk about beauty, right? Oftentimes, when we talk about beauty, it's in regards to a woman, right? Everybody thinks a woman is beautiful. There's a beautiful woman movement out here. You know, black is beautiful, white is beautiful, thick is beautiful, slim is beautiful, natural is beautiful, you know, makeup is beautiful. It all comes in all forms of women. It's beautiful, right? I kind of want to speak about the gift and the curse of the beautiful black man, right? Not even a beautiful black man, the beautiful man, a man who is looked at in society as handsome, a guy who's physically fit, spends time and energy on his wardrobe, who carries himself well, who holds conversations, and more specifically, the guy who was born that way, the guy who was able to do that in, you know, the fifth and sixth and seventh grade, who was groomed up doing that. I mean, it's truly a gift. I think about all the trouble I escaped because I have long eyelashes and I speak well and I'm kind of handsome. The way I could talk to certain people about certain things and they would be more willing to receive what I was saying. Such a gift, right? In reality, though, it's both a gift and a curse. Anything that's good can be bad in the wrong setting, in the wrong situation. Oftentimes, especially in the black man, that teaches us how to be manipulative. You know, it teaches us how to use people and situations to our best ability. You know, it teaches us how to scheme and find a way to wiggle our way outside of the issues and the troubles that we put ourselves into. And then, what happens when life hits, man? I'm noticing every day in the community that I'm in now as I work hard to help black men, that we've become spoiled, not because life is easy, but because we've been running game for so long. We've been doing for so long the things that make other people happy, the things that seem to make other people happy, the things that make other people feel good. You know, we talk right in the group of white folks who don't like our aggression, and we talk tough in the group of our friends who need to see that as our manliness, and then we talk smooth with the ladies when it's proper, and then we're you know, that manipulation, that gift and that curse of beauty turned us into chameleons. It's so hard when you've lived your life as a chameleon, when you learn to blend in everywhere you're at, to your advantage and to the advantage of the people around you. See, because then you wake up and you're 25, 30, 35, 40 years old, and although you know who you are, no one else does. No matter what you do, no one else truly knows your heart because you've had to wear so many coats. I know this same gift and curse isn't uncommon to other people. I just truly believe it's all the way unspoken of in the African American male community. We like to say that we're super real, that we're super thorough, we stick to the script, when the script is unwritten. There's not no written way on how to be a successful, strong black man. There's no manual on what you need to do and how you need to become you. In most situations, we grew up lacking male influence. Even with fathers in the home, we didn't have the influence, someone to say, hey, it's okay for you to be you. the streets told us to be like the streets, and the school told us to be like school, and church told us to be like church, and the police told us to be like the ones who weren't getting caught. I think midlife crisis is an amazing thing, an amazing indication. Not that we're going crazy, but that we're figuring out that we were going crazy trying to be anyone but ourselves. I'm trying to make a vow, a pledge to myself that I'll be true to me for the rest of my life, that I'll be true to who I am, that I'll figure out every day, one moment and one day at a time, that I am me. And I have to love it and live it. That it's more than talking, it's more than walking, but it's believing in who God created me to be in. Going all in at it. But I am Richard, and I am certainly dumb.